I was very scared at that moment when he pointed that gun at me. In that moment, I was being reminded of what happened to Gauri Lankesh, and I thought that moment has arrived. A person came with a gun, tried to overpower me, tried to shoot me down. Thankfully, my friends were there with me, who tried to overpower him in return, and he ran away and he fired from across the road. What has happened in the last 2 years is that there has been such a disinformation, propaganda, hateful campaign that has been spread across by certain media houses, by troll armies of the ruling party, where anyone who opposes the present government, who questions the present government, who stands by and just questions about certain policies of the government, they are branded anti-national, they are branded all kinds of things, and then anything can be done to them. I was very scared at that moment when he pointed that gun at me. In that moment, I was being reminded of what happened to Gauri Lankesh, and I thought that moment has arrived. I'm really thankful to my friends who are present there that they could overpower him and I survived. देखिए हम तो यहाँ सवाल करने ही आए थे. अगर ये इंसिडेंट नहीं भी होता तो हम सवाल करने आए थे कि हमको खौफ से आज़ादी चाहिए. यहाँ बहुत सारे ऐसे लोग हैं जिनके घर वालों को मार दिया है. कभी भीड़ ने मारा, कभी किसी और तरीके से मारा गया, कभी किसी लोगों की हत्याएं हुई. और ये कब तक जिएंगे? मतलब आज एक तरफ देश में बदहाली है और जो लोग सवाल पैदा कर रहे हैं, सवाल उठा रहे हैं, उनको डराने की, धमकाने की, उनको चुप कराने की साजिश है.
Delhi police who have come here are claiming that there was no incident of firing. Many eyewitnesses say that they indeed saw two unknown assailants who came and shot at the student activist. He was, however, surrounded by his friends, and they say that there is just a gash on his arm. However, the Delhi police are investigating and they are maintaining that there has been no incident of firing.
जब ये लोग बाहर एक ढाबे पर चाय पी रहे थे, उस वक्त इनके ऊपर एक आदमी ने पीछे से हमला किया, जिसमें ये गिर गए. बाकी जो और तमाम चीज़ें हैं, इन्वेस्टिगेशन किया जा रहा है, कंप्लेंट ली जा रही है, FIR रजिस्टर की जा रही है, और जो भी इसमें लीगल एक्शन बनता है वो इंश्योर किया जाएगा. अभी मेडिकल एग्जामिनेशन उनका करा रहे हैं. बाकी वो स्वस्थ हैं, सुरक्षित हैं, कोई ऐसी विजिबल इंजरी नहीं है, लेकिन धक्का मुक्की जो हुई है उसमें उनके कपड़े गंदे.
I don't think this is more to create a kind of sensationalization, because nobody's been hurt, and I'm happy that nobody's been hurt. And I'm sure there was a firing, but firing was done with the purpose of intimidation, or was done with the intention of sending a message, or was done to cause chaos, or it was only a propaganda mechanism. I think police will do its job.
संघ परिवार और भाजपा के लोग लगातार पिछले 2 साल से एक सोची समझी साजिश और षड्यंत्र के चलते बार बार उमर खालिद को टुकड़े टुकड़े गैंग, राष्ट्रद्रोही बताकर जो बदनाम कर रहे थे, उसको वल्नरेबल बना रहे थे, उसी के चलते आज उमर खालिद पे हमला हुआ है. मैं साफ तौर पे मानता हूँ ये वही लोगों का कारस्थान हो सकता है जिन लोगों ने गौरी लंकेश, दाभोलकर जी, पानसरे और कलबुर्गी को मारा है. संघ परिवार और भाजपा के अलावा कोई नहीं हो सकता है जो उमर खालिद पर हमला करे, और इसलिए न केवल मैं उसकी निंदा करता हूँ, माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी को इस मामले में मुंह खोलना चाहिए और इमीडिएटली उनको पुलिस प्रोटेक्शन प्रोवाइड करना चाहिए.
The attack on Umar Khalid is it's an act of terror, and people who have done this, they are obviously brainwashed by right-wing ideology. They are obviously brainwashed by hate propaganda that is carried out by the ruling party, and that is carried out by certain TV channels which say things to the effect that these people are anti-nationals, these people are urban Naxals, these people are traitors, and all of those things.